It is not the will of God for you to live a life conformed to this world. It is not the will of God for our lives to have a passion or desire or a craving for the world after He bought us with His shed blood. See, once we claim to be a Christian and love God, we should not be attached to this world any longer. That was our old self, our sinful nature. See, we are supposed to be dead to this flesh. All that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life. It's not of the Father, but it's of the world. But whoever does the will of God abides forever. Whoever does the will of God has eternal life. And that life is in Jesus, and Jesus only. We've got to be committed to the will of the Father. The whole duty of man is to fear God and keep His commandments. The Word of God says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength." See, God wants all of us, not some of us, all of us. We need to be dead to this flesh, so that we can allow the Spirit, the miraculous power of Christ in us, to live through us. See, that's what happens when we die to this flesh. Christ will live in our lives. He'll live in us. He'll manifest through us. He'll work in us to will and to do, giving us the ability to take action, to go after spiritual things, the things that He has said. So no desire for the world, no passion for the world, no craving for the world. Don't attach yourself to this world, because it has nothing to offer you but death and separation from the blessings of God in your life. We have to keep ourselves, and this has just been pulling at me, we have to keep ourselves away from the world. We cannot escape the world. We're surrounded by it. But we don't have to live as if we belong to the world. We belong to the kingdom of God. His kingdom, His dominion, His righteousness, His joy, His peace, His ways. See, that is who we belong to, not this world.